This shop is but a mask, concealing the face of the Tremere in their lair. What wonders are these? 'Tis as if the Tree of Knowledge and the Tree of Life have rooted in this terrible place.
These are magicked trees. The Tremere revel in their thaumaturgical power to reshape the world to their purposes.
Even the humble fruits of the earth are weapons to the Tremere.
Then let us reap a harvest of unliving mages.
I do withdraw.
We have found the roots of the great trees and perhaps the root of Tremere.
What
power.
Wickedness do they brew here?
Return to me!
To the abyss with thee!
I do withdraw. Return to me!
To the abyss with thee!
With you.
I do withdraw. I do withdraw. Return to me.
To the abyss with thee. I do withdraw. Attend me. To the abyss with thee. Stop.
It burns.
To the abyss with thee.
I do withdraw. Tend me.
Interlopers.
To the abyss with thee. To the abyss with thee.
Tend me.
This is no place to be. Flee, and I shall spare thee.
I do withdraw. Return to me.
I am weak with lack of precious blood. It burns! I do withdraw. Attend me. Shipping manifest for the October slave shipment. To be shipped, 7 mortal slaves and 3 Kainite prisoners. The Ventru caravan master Count Orsi shall ship the slaves to the House de Hexi in Vienna.
We have found prisoners.
Thou art free of thy bondage by the power of the Prometheans.
Thanks upon thanks to thee for releasing us. Ye have saved us surely. Blessings upon ye, stranger.
Mm-hmm.
I do withdraw.
Unto thee.
Behold.
abyss with me! To the abyss with me!
What manner of canine have they imprisoned here? He seems more animal than man.
Thou hast saved Erik of Clan Gangrel. According to the ancient canine law, I owe thee a life boon. I shall accompany thee and protect thee until such time as I discharge my debt.
Thou speaks with honor.
Thy providential attack did interrupt the wicked sorcerer Ardan, as he began a conjuration to twist me into a mindless gargoyle. At the sound of thy coming, the Tremere snake slithered into the chambers below. I am thine to command. After I have felt the Tremere's shriveled heart burst between my jaws!
Thou mayst tear the warlock's heart from his chest only after I have pried truthful answers from his mouth. Now let us go.
Attack me! I shall give thee all thy desires!
Hold, Ardan. I am Christoph Romuald of Clan Bruja. Where is Aneska?
Welcome, Christoph Romuald. Ah, yes. An intriguing woman came unto me. A nun she was. And she was my first nun. She was the first nun who ever came seeking me. Aneska, her name. She sought the lore of the kindred. She sought our secrets. And she sought to learn of thee, Christoph. I was intrigued with such audacity.
Come to the point, Magus.
She seemed to have no fear. No fear at all. I was dumbstruck. She seemed possessed of the courage of 100 warriors, yet I could smell her fear. Well aware she was of the risk she ran, was she filled with arrogant self-righteousness? No. She knew her God would not protect her from my hunger. Did she seek martyrdom? No. She clearly clung to her life and lived life with a passion I had not seen before in a nun. Was she mad? Or a mere fool? No. Behind her quiet words, there lurked a cunning mind. I did not know what she was. And in not knowing, I was intrigued. Intrigued and strangely drawn to her.
I care not for thy loathsome appetite, Sardan. What became of her?
And she was quite beautiful. Didst thou know? Couldst thou see that behind her wimple, that her hair was long and auburn? Couldst thou see that beneath the shapeless folds of her robe, that she possessed a body as achingly beautiful as any odalisk? Truly, she chose the wrong profession to make the best use of the gifts God had bestowed upon her. In defiance of heaven, she had buried her talents in the field of the holy orders. Her beauty transfixed me, just as her courage thrilled me. I had never met a woman like her, and I shall never again. I had to have her. I had to make her my own child.
If thou dare to defile her in such a way, I swear, I will burn thee to ash an inch at a time.
Thou might show more charity to the only one who can find her.
He baits thee, Christoph, and dawdles for some treacherous purpose. Pray, let me kill him!
Ardan, if thou dost fail to tell me where she is with thy next breath, Erik will behead thee before thou draw breath again.
I know not. I touched her not, but merely sent her away to the Tzimitzi.
Dost thou take me for a fool? Why wouldst thou send one thou lusted for to thy hated enemy?
My sire would not allow me another child, and I dared not defy him. But I could not bear the thought of another embracing her. So I sent her to the Tzimitzi. They are the only clan that would have no use for one such as she, so I could be sure they would not embrace her. They would simply kill her, thinking her a part of some Tremere scheme.
Devil-tongued fiend! Thou hast sent her to her death! Die!
Wait! She did return from the Tzimitzi!
What?
Liar! The Tzimitzi would have killed her.
Peace! Let him speak.
I asked her how she survived, and she said, her faith sustains her in all things. She even thanked me for sending her to the Tzimitzi. Ah, a most remarkable woman. My spies did tell of a premise revenant that did cower before the pure light of her faith, and sobbing like a child, whispered to her of Golconda.
Golconda? What is that?
The belief that a vampire can be redeemed, cured of the blood of Cain. Tis but a legend, and no more, told to give comfort to weak-willed canines. Yet no one knows more of Golconda than the great Tremere master, Atreus. She said she would go to him in his Chantry in Vienna. She even asked to ride to Vienna in our October caravan of slaves. What a woman!
Where is she? Tell me, or I will split thee in twain!
I delivered her to the Ventru caravan driver, Orsi, and they left 3 days ago for Vienna.
Dog! Thou hast enslaved her!
Ha! Master Atreus will take great delight in her. And now I have finished casting the spell that will destroy thee, thou love-struck clotpole!
Ardan, I will slay thee if it is my last act on earth!
Ah! hasten our victory. Come, we return to the university in triumph.
Very well, but then I shall go to Vienna and reclaim fair Aneska from these cursed warlocks.